We've come a long way in the last few decades when it comes to body positivity and all the embracing of all shapes and all sizes, but we're not out of the woods yet. Criticism of people's weight still persists. Well, it certainly did last week when speaking with AIM, former The Real Housewives of Auckland star Louise Wallace implied the body positivity movements led to overweight bodies being normalised in the media.
Hey, fundamental that, just tape over people's mouths with gaffer tape.
Oh.
I mean, you know,
so
I mean,
say it's
sooner
numbers,
or later, yeah, but
people.
Sooner or later, surely it's what goes in here and what people. And I think that unfortunately we have normalised the idea of being overweight, normalised it. And I'll give you an example.
But if we flip the script, it isn't the normalisation of all bodies a positive. For more, we're joined by Justine Shearer, creator of My Balance Project. Morena.
Hi, thank how you. Are you?
Yeah, good. I mean, did you bristle as much as I did during that?
Yeah, I did. It really got down quite deep, actually, as it did for a lot of people.
Yeah, no doubt. Valerie Adams was one that responded.
Mm-hmm. She's great.
To that as a Pacifica, beautiful, mm-hmm. you know, strong,
strong
woman.
Strong picture of health.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yep. So tell us about your story in the first instance and why that incensed you so much.
I have had weight loss issues all my life, like, I want to say since a child. I don't necessarily know where it, you know, completely came from at that stage. But yeah, I've always had weight issues. I've always struggled. I have polycystic ovary syndrome that I was diagnosed with when I was 14. So some fairly major hormonal issues, which actually affects like over, I think, 50% of women in New Zealand. And I've gained and lost over 35 kilos three times in my adult life. So I really, really know what it feels like to be in that position of like having judgment from, you know, the community around you and society and not having any representation growing up. There was no one in fashion or in media that was over a size 12, as Louise called, normal. And when I looked around me, there was a lot of people like me, but we weren't represented anywhere. So you are, you know, it's implied that you are not normal and that there's something wrong with you. So I started a page about 4 years ago called My Balance Project on Instagram, to talk about, you know, women's bodies and women's health. And I was on my own weight loss journey at the time and it just kind of blew up. And a lot of people were really interested in what I was wearing because at the time there was not a lot of people who were showing that they could be fashionable in a plus size body or that they could, you know, have their own personal style and wear whatever they wanted. So that kind of things just blew up for me and I became really passionate about encouraging women to, yeah, wear what they want no matter what size they are, to, you know, have acceptance for themselves, have love for themselves and normalize being over a size 10 or a size 12. And yeah, so for me, I spend all my time doing that and trying to lift people up. And I just really found that her comments were not helpful and it's not going to solve any problems by trying to make people who've already had lifelong issues feel even worse about themselves. Like, that's not going to help anybody.
Yeah, well, I guess if you're going to talk about that flip side, then you need to have the discussion about the other side in terms of modelling. And we know the mm-hmm. issues that, and we've actually interviewed a couple on the show talking about the issues that they've had mm-hmm. in the modelling world of having to lose weight and the issues
on the other end of
on the
spectrum.
Flip side, yeah. side of it, you mm-hmm. know, and the mental issues that created for them as well. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, let's move on mm-hmm. from those comments mm-hmm. and actually. This is, this has actually started a good conversation about, which is exactly what you have yep. been doing, about how we should view our bodies. And I think, you know, like I'm going through menopause and I've got a puku,
yep.
you know, and my body has completely changed
yep.
from, you know, a few years ago. And that's tough to deal with at different stages.
Yes, yeah, it is. And I think that's a really important point for women is to understand that we do evolve and that we do change and that our bodies as they were when we were 18 years old, as some people would say, like in your prime, you know, that's not what you're going to be, you know, but that's what people look back to when they're 18 and they're like, oh man, I wish I had that body again. You're not going to have that body again.
Oh, let it go, sister.
You're not going to have that body again because you're now, you know, 40 or like I am 45. So I think understanding that, you know, you do evolve and you carry children and there's different mental health issues that happen, different trauma that you're dealing with. So I think people need to have more empathy for themselves. So not only do other people need to have more empathy for others and have a little bit of understanding, which is what I was, you know, really disappointed about Louise's comments, is having it for yourself as well, and knowing that, you know, your body goes through a lot and you need to kind of be along there with it on its, on the journey, not treating it like it's your enemy, you know. So I'm all about, yeah, okay, we've got pukus and we've got, you know, everything else going on that maybe we don't like, but it's still our body, and it does more for us than just, it's not just something to look at. How does it function, you know? Like, what is it? Anyone who knows sports will know, you know, you focus on all these incredible things that it can do for you rather than just, you know, how a pair of jeans or underwear sits on you type thing, you know?
Yeah. It consumes our thoughts too much, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really, really does. And it's super hard for people who've had a lot of weight loss issues. You know, I've had so many weight loss issues in my life. I had weight loss surgery 4 months ago. And so for me, you know, comments that are made are really triggering, because you think, you know, I've gone through so much that's what I decided to do. I went through something really, really major to get my health back on track. And a lot of that is largely due to stupid comments that are made by people about our bodies that just aren't important, you know? So, yeah, there's a lot of people out there who are trying really hard to look after themselves, and it's hard when there's kind of that
negative narrative that's sitting around it.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, because I know it's not easy to come on and talk about your own stuff.
Yeah, thank
you. So I see that and I appreciate that. And I know our audience will as well, because you know, everybody's going through their own stuff.
I've got a lot of followers who are like, we can't talk, so please talk for us. So, yeah, beautiful. I hope I've done that justice.
Justine, thank you so much.
Thank
good
you.
To see you. Really appreciate it. Nice jacket too. Good colour.
Yeah, great.